Good morning and welcome to everyone. I'm Jean-Paul Pélissier, Deputy Manager of SIAM Montpellier, and with Samuel Ferret, who will moderate the last session of the conference, we coordinate the Eco-Waste for Food project, an inter-regional project funded by EU. And it's a pleasure for me to introduce this online conference in the name of all the project team you will discover all around the day. I would like first to thank all the participants and panelists that will intervene during this day for making themselves available to share their experiences and ideas. Many thanks also to all the attendees, which number we have 240 people who registered this conference, so which number demonstrates the relevance of the food waste issue, and I hope this conference will reach the expectations of all. The objective of the conference are twofold. First, to share the activities and results of the project. This will be done this morning. And second, in the afternoon, to debate on two main issues regarding the aim at reducing food waste. First, how can local authorities take up this issue? And second, what are the opportunities given by the new European strategies and policies, and in particular by the Green Deal. Without further delay, I give the floor to Mr. Placido Plaza, the Secretary General of SIAM, to introduce this conference together with Ms. Anne Rocheteau from the Interreg Europe Programme. Placido, the floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Jean-Paul. And thank you to all of you to welcome me in this group. I will try to be as briefly as possible to give you an insight on why the topic of your project matters to SIAM and to its member countries. I will just, as a very quick introduction, we have to know that SIAM is an intergovernmental organization composed of 13 member countries that is devoted to sustainable agriculture and fisheries, to food and nutrition security, and the development of rural and coastal territories in the Mediterranean. These are, to our understanding, key issues for the societies and economies of our regions. And we consider that the development of the future and the future of this region depend and will depend in first hand of their harmonious development. The activities of SIAM are based on a combination of resources and tools that includes education, capacity building, network research, cooperation, and as well as policy dialogue. SIAM is one of the longest established actors in multilateral cooperation and dialogue in the Euro-Mediterranean partnership. Throughout these years, we have consistently elaborated and fine-tuned our priorities to adapt to changes occurring and challenges facing the region. Combating waste is certainly one of them that is now high on our agenda of priorities. The COVID-19 crisis has reminded us forcefully that we must develop food systems that are not only good for the planet, good for its inhabitants, but are also a base for the good health of our societies. Fighting against food waste is definitely a sign of our society's good health. Today, our world is characterized by two opposite situations in relation to food status. Abundance and waste on one side, scarcity on the other. According to FAO, one third of what is produced is lost or wasted. If just 25% of what is lost and wasted could be avoided, we would be able to feed worldwide an additional 800 million of hungry people. Abundance of knowledge, inherited and continuously produced, which does not always reach the right people at the right moment. Abundance of resources and energy wasted due to infrastructure misfunctioning or to misuse. And of course, abundance of food, of which 30% is wasted. This triple waste is of concern to SIAM. First, because abundance is only apparent, and what in reality our basic resources are becoming more and more scarce, name it water, soil, biodiversity, but also knowledge production and the gradual phasing out of traditional know-how. So today, it is more than ever imperative to optimize the use of all these resources. Waste is also closely linked to inequality of access, because people live in remote areas, or they are jobless, or because of their gender or the climate impact. So in that sense, questioning waste and questioning food waste in particular is a way to recognize and to have a starting point to address the increasing inequality of the distribution of goods. Combating food waste gives new values to food, and by doing so, we provide new values to our society as a whole by raising awareness on the scarcity of primary resources, by recreating social links among people, between farmers and producers, between retailers and charity organizations, by promoting new and innovative value chains that support the reinforcement of the local economy and the development of more efficient economies. Therefore, and because food is a vital good for all of us, the commitment at the local level to fight against its waste with the setting up of participative and territorialized strategies, and I insist on this, participative and territorialized strategies, appears as a strong lever to engage our society in a new paradigm where resources will be considered as a common good and managed carefully and shared. A peaceful and prosperous Mediterranean won't be possible without food security, without sustainable agricultural systems, responsible management and use of natural resources, and without an inclusive development of rural areas and vulnerable communities. Wasting food, wasting natural resources and human talents contributes to waste our common future. Your project, by addressing especially the local authorities, has in a way opened a door, and the pertinent result it has produced, we hope, will trace a way and a path that SIAM is in which SIAM is willing to accompany you. So thank you very much for welcoming me in this opening session, and we will be looking carefully to the results of your project. We have, with our colleagues in Montpellier, and Jean-Paul in particular, very reliable focal points. So thank you so much again, and have a good day of work.
Many thanks, Placido, for this introduction that clearly shows, I think, the strong challenges we have to deal with when addressing the waste issue, the triple waste for us.
Thank you, Jean-Paul. I'm going to share with you a presentation. Sorry, it seems that it's disabled. Okay. Now I have it. Okay, sorry for that. Can you see it? Yeah, okay, good, thank you. Okay, so I'm very happy to be with you today, even though, well, we have to keep the distance and it's only virtually, but I will be with you. And our meeting together today means that we're getting to the end of this project, Takeaways for Food, a good project supported by Interreg Europe. And as we see today, after 4 years of learning and exchanges, we see so many participants. I hear 240 participants today. This shows indeed that it's a very successful project, and that the topic of food waste reduction also is very specific but concerns all of us. So I'm happy to be part of this day with you. And I'm going to make a short presentation before you dig into this topic. I'm going to make this short presentation on Interreg Europe program. First, I will talk about the results of the program, and then I will talk a little bit about the future, what will come next. So, Interreg Europe program, we support in the current programming period, we support 248 projects. And the whole amount that was available for this budget was 322 million euros has been allocated to projects. We support projects in all European countries, and our specificity is that we support the regions, the nuts, as we say in our jargon. 1/4 of our project partners are managing authorities. As our director used to say, we are a program for the regions, by the regions. I suggest I will take the question after the presentation. I see that a hand was raised. If you don't mind, I will take the question afterwards. What do we do with Interreg Europe? We support learning exchanges. How? With good practices. The project partners submit good practices from their regions. We assess them, and here you see that 2/3 of the good practices have been validated and have a good quality so that they could be published on the policy learning platform that we here shorten as PLP. I will talk about it later. What else do we do? We support capacity building. As you can see here, the indicator defined for this programming period has already been achieved in terms of capacity building, even though only half of our project, a little bit more than half of our projects, have just reported about these indicators. They report on it at the end of phase one. So it's quite a success from our projects. The action plans are about policy changes in the regions. This is what we look at, especially policy changes. Why? Because this shows that the investment of Interreg Europe has impact in terms of investment in the regions. Here, 1 euro invested by Interreg Europe in a project generates 4.2 euros of investment in a region. This is the leverage effect that is very good. And as I said, not all projects have reported yet. We are just in the middle of the reporting. So we still have some years to go, and this should improve as well. So this result is also very good thanks to the project. The second pillar of the program Interreg Europe is the policy learning platform. Here is a community of peers where you can find good practices, and you can find also some support of experts. The one activity that I can describe is the peer reviews. Peer reviews are 2 days of meeting among peers where a region hosts the meeting and discusses on the specific problem raised by this region. This is very successful. It's very intense, but it's very successful. And so far we organized 16 peer reviews and 8 are in the pipeline still. So I just invite you to check the website of the Policy Learning Platform. You can consult the information there, the good practices, and you can also contribute. Another page where you can also contribute and that can be useful for you is a page that we just created recently, obviously, and that is related to COVID-19. here you can find, well, our program is about traveling, about meeting, about learning exchange. So of course, with COVID-19, we've been impacted, our projects have been impacted. So we intended to Swift online this exchange and provide this page for good practices available on how to tackle COVID-19 impact. So for the moment, we have about 20 good practices here available, but you are you can contribute also if you have practices from your region on one challenge faced through COVID-19 crisis. Do not hesitate to send it to us and we will publish it. And we will also offer you the possibility to participate to the activities on this webpage. So please, this is for you, this is for learning exchange, and this is available for all. Now, because our program wouldn't exist without the projects, let's talk a little bit about the projects. Eco Waste for Food is a project on TO6 and especially on resource efficiency. There are 31 projects on the resource efficiency, and here you can see the partners in the different countries who take part in this project. We mentioned a few of them: BioRegio, Circe, Winpol, who tackle food waste question. However, and you can find them in their good practices on their webpage. Eco Waste for Food is the only project that tackles food waste reduction. And I want to mention that Eco Waste for Food was quite successful in terms of exchange among partners. We could see that there was a real exchange, a real learning between the partners, and the project was very active in the program. They submitted to us several good practices. 25 good practices are on the website of Eco Waste for Food, and most of them have been validated and published on the policy learning platform, which is quite a good number compared to other projects, to be honest. It's a very good number. Eco Waste for Food, where several partners also intervene in several events organized by Interreg Europe and the European Week of Regions and Cities, for example, last year. Eco Waste for Food has been very, very active on social networks. Twitter, almost 500 followers on Twitter, which is quite impressive for a project, very good. And not to forget to mention the two pilot actions, which mean that from the learning exchange, two partners in UK and in Poland learned and tested some practices learned from other countries. So this is very good result of the project. And finally, 6 policy changes in 5 regions, which is also a very good result. I'm not going to take more time on this research because I guess you will be talking about it during the day. I just want to say congratulations to the whole team of Eco Waste for Food. You did a very good work, and we are very happy to support you. We can see these results are very concrete. Discussing with my colleagues, Marie, we thought also that your topic is very specific: food waste reduction. And maybe this could help in having a good concentration of efforts on this topic, a good involvement of partners, of stakeholders that could help you achieve these good results. So again, congratulations. Now, Eco Waste for Food is getting to the end. I guess you will be continuing working and exchanging on the topic. And I'm happy to announce that Interreg Europe will continue as well in the coming years. And next programming period, we will be back. So the negotiation was a bit unsure in the last years, but now we are sure that we will be back in the next programming period. On our website, you can find all the information with the current cooperation program that is being discussed and negotiated. You can look at it, you can also comment it, and you can find information in terms of deadlines, how we plan to have it approved. For now, we hope to have the cooperation program approved by the end of 2021. So this means that a first call wouldn't be launched before the beginning of 2022. the next programming period, there will be no big revolution for entire Europe, but there will be some evolution, definitely. We will keep our scope with working with all European countries. We will keep our objective. We will keep the same target groups, the regions. We will keep our focus on capacity building. What are our proposals now that are being negotiated? First, the policy instrument will not necessarily have to be linked to an operational program. This is a good news for TO6, yeah, indeed. So we are quite happy if this is approved. The second proposal is to have more pilot actions and to have the possibility to do them earlier during the project. Maybe test some action already during the first years of the project. And the last proposal is to have only one priority in the program, that would be capacity building of the staff or the stakeholders, and not anymore a thematic scope of the program. There will be no more thematic priority. So all this has to be approved. We are still in the negotiation, but here are the ideas for the future. We hope that we just invite you to keep yourself informed on this negotiation on our website and through contacting us. We hope that you will be to find many of you in the next programming period with us. For today, I wish you a very fruitful discussion, good exchanges among yourselves and on the topic of food waste reduction, which is on the agenda of the European Commission as well, and that's very good timing. And again, I want to say thank you and congratulations to the team of EcoWaste for Food. Have a good day.
Thank you, Anne, to provide us with this presentation of the Interreg Europe program and the future. Thank you too for what you said about the EcoWaste for Food. It gives us confidence on the future of what we try to do. So thank you. I must say that this is a program I really appreciate for two things. First, regarding the dialogue that exists between the Joint Secretary and the candidates during the phase of formulation of the program. Of the project, and it's something we don't see often, and it's really fruitful when you have an idea, you try to build the project, to be able to discuss with the manager of the program, and it's a very good souvenir for me. And the second point is regarding the place given to exchanges and dialogue between partners all along the project. It's something very, very interesting. You say this about EcoWaste, that we have built a real and strong dialogue and exchange, and it's a reality. So thank you.